just want to get ready.
Hey guys, so I may look bald headed right now, but I actually have my hair braided because I'm supposed to like sew my hair in tonight. I'm not really sure if I want to do it though because I feel kind of tired. I got up, I did my makeup. I didn't dress up or anything like that. I just did my makeup and I went outside and I went to go pick up a few things, but I ended up just getting like 2 items for myself and 1 item for Kai. She doesn't really need nothing, so I just got her some socks. And then I saw this really cute like jeans dress, so I picked that up for myself. And I also picked up a long boots that I've been dying to have like since forever, because I'm like, you know what, I've been wanting them for like forever now, so I might as well just get it and get it out the way. And then I also wanted this other like jersey dress, but it's more like for the summer anyway. The color is a really nice fall color, but it's short sleeve and then it's short and it has splits on the side, and I feel like it's more for the summertime. And the boots that I got can be for summer, spring, winter, fall, like every season it can work for, because it just has like a little peep toe. And even if you wear them in the winter, you could always wear them with like long jeans or whatever. So now I'm supposed to sew my hair in. I feel lazy. I don't feel like doing it. Yeah, I'm just here. I was only gonna go to get one thing in particular. And now, like, I regret getting the jersey, the jeans dress that I got. But then at the same time, I feel like I can wear it any way that I want to. I can wear it, you know, with jeans and some boots, high heel boots. I can wear them, you know, with some long flat boots and some leggings. So, you know, the jeans dress is versatile, so I can wear it with almost anything, and I can, like, you know, do it like that. I wanted to do like a little lookbook on how I like would probably dress up my jeans dresses and stuff like that. They're not dresses, but you can wear them like a dress, and they're like, they're really long, they're cute, and they have like the splits on the sides. My subscribers went up again, my views went up again by a whole 200 and something views, basically overnight, because last night it wasn't like that, and when I woke up this morning it went all the way up. And then I'm gonna check back in with you guys a little bit later. I really do apologize for the fact that most of my I don't feel like my vlogs are really that entertaining because I don't go outside much, but I do have a 2-year-old and I don't have my stroller here. My stroller is actually at my mother's house, so it's kind of difficult for me to take her outside all the time, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I'm gonna check back in with you guys a little bit later. Yeah, so I'll see you guys a little bit later. Bye. Hello people. So I just got up from a nap. I am so exhausted. Last night I did laundry. I didn't get back in until after 12. I am so exhausted. And the night before, Kailani kept me up until 7 o'clock in the morning. I fell asleep around 8 something. So, I mean, I got like 8, 9, 10, like 4 hours of sleep before my mother came ringing the bell. And I was with her, talking with her for a couple hours until she went to go pick up my brothers and stuff. I wanted to talk about BeautyCon, okay? Did you guys freaking see BeautyCon New York? Oh my gosh. Yo, I was so down to go this year. Like, I was like pumped. I was like, I'm going. I was like, I'm saving my money, I'm getting my ticket early, I'm gonna go. And I don't know what the heck happened. Like, literally around the time when I was supposed to be ordering the ticket, I didn't have the money yet. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna wait, and then when I get the money, I'm gonna purchase the tickets. Every time I needed to purchase a ticket or do something for myself or something like that, something else always comes up. So I end up not being able to do the things that I want to do because I always put other things, of course, that are more important than the things that I want to do. But it was so important for me to go to BeautyCon this year because every single YouTuber that I watch on YouTube on a daily basis was there. And I was so annoyed because I could not believe that I missed seeing all these people. Like, what the hell? Like, I'm still mad. Like, I'm still like thinking about it. Like, I can't believe I missed BeautyCon. Last minute, about a week before BeautyCon, people were like, oh, go here, get the tickets, get the tickets. One girl that I watched, I checked to see if they had, and they had she had those tickets. So then I was like, oh, okay, so I can wait a couple days, and then when I, get this little bit of change, because I had, I had a bill to pay. So it's like, okay, let me, when I get this little change, I'm gonna go and I'm gonna buy this ticket, since it's probably gonna be sold out soon, because every single other one was sold out. When I went on there, it was sold out. Then I watched another YouTuber that posted it to her YouTube. And when I checked on her YouTube through her link, the tickets were sold out once again. So I said, you know what? I guess I'm not supposed to go this year. And I was so disappointed because, like, I knew what I wanted my hairstyle to be like. I knew what outfit I wanted to wear. I knew what shoes I wanted to wear. I knew what lipstick I wanted to wear. I knew what makeup look I wanted to go for. I was gonna look so cute at BeautyCon, but unfortunately, I didn't get to go, and I'm so disappointed. And I'm looking at all the little goodie bags. You guys, they gave away so much free stuff. Oh my gosh, they gave away so much free stuff. The amount of stuff that I see Shea Moisture stuff. I see beauty blenders that they gave away. I see shampoos, conditioners. Last year in LA, because I didn't know, the one in LA, they gave them a big beauty bag too, but it wasn't as much as stuff as New York was offering this year. Like, yeah, they gave away so much stuff. I was watching LaToya Forever. Her bags were crazy. Because she Aquarius just like me. So I know she was going to get everything that was free that she could get. Because that's just how I am too. Like, who don't want to get free makeup? Like, they gave away eyeshadows, lipsticks, like so much stuff, you guys. And I missed it. I'm so disappointed that I missed BeautyCon. Like, to the point where I'm watching other people's videos that went. And I'm like, you know what? I'm mad at y'all because y'all went and I didn't get to go. Made me so mad. I can't believe like I really missed it. But God's willing, next year I'll be able to go. I'm gonna make sure I save up all my coins, okay? Get this outfit together, get this hair together, and I'm gonna make sure my butt is in BeautyCon next year, God's willing, because it was just not right that I was not there, okay? BeautyCon was not supposed to happen without Tanya, and it happened without Tanya, and that was not supposed to happen because it was my plan to go from the jump. Okay, like it's been a dream of mine to always go, and I have a beauty channel. Of course, BeautyCon would be an event that I would definitely want to basically go to, see what's there, watch the panel. Meet big YouTubers, maybe talk to them, maybe talk to them about my channel, see what tips they could give me. Like, I was just really looking forward to it. One day I would like to go to the one in LA, but I heard that their goodie bags aren't all of that. It could just be the YouTuber that I watched, but as far as from what I've seen YouTubers show that they got from LA, I wasn't really too impressed. So I had a dream just now that I had a big ass anaconda snake in my clothes. Now, the anaconda was supposed to be running from the head, was supposed to be in my slippers, in like almost in between my toes, and then the rest of its body was just under my jeans, running up my shirt. And for some reason, in the dream, I fell asleep and the snake got inside of my shirt somehow, away from the original way that it was. And I'm just like, what the hell does it mean when you dream about snakes? Now, My mom told me that anytime you have a dream about snakes, it's evil. It's an evil, type of dream. So I don't really know. I wasn't thinking about snakes. I didn't watch any snakes on TV. I just fell asleep and I dreamt about a snake. I remember dreaming about a snake before. And I remember the snake had bit me, but this was a couple of years ago. But today, I'm just like, So maybe one of you could tell me what you think dreaming of a snake means, because I'm just like, what the heck? Like, why did I dream about a snake? And I know for a fact that whenever my mother and my grandmother, hear about snakes in a dream, they say it's evil. There's something evil. It could be a person that's evil, that's trying to, mess with you, or that's trying to, bring you down. But if that's the case, I'm just gonna pray tonight and just pray all that evil away, because at the end of the day, there's always a higher power, and God will always defeat evil. So I am not even worried about that. I just want to know what you guys think dreaming of a snake means, because in my family, my background, they believe that snakes, if you dream about snakes, it's something evil. So I don't know, but I just wanted to chit chat with you guys for a little bit before I ended this vlog. You guys, like I said earlier, I apologize for these vlogs that are just in the house, but just bear with me. My vlogs will become more exciting, and I will try to go out a little bit more just so that you guys can be a little bit more entertained. I know I'm tired of seeing me sitting in one place talking too. So, like I said, I am going to try. Like, when you have a 2-year-old and you want to run here and you want to run there, it's a process you have to go through to get these kids ready. In my case, my child is like two kids in one. That's the main big problem, is that my stroller is freaking huge and it can't fit nowhere. So literally, I can't take the bus with it, and if I do take the train with it, I need help going up and down the steps with it, because it's a big stroller. It's a mama's and papa's stroller. So I was thinking to clean it up and then sell it, and then but before I clean it up and sell it, I'm still gonna try to get a smaller stroller so that I can be more mobile with her, because I'm telling you, that stroller is way too big. Like, if I'm going anywhere, I have to plan ahead. What would you like my first comeback video to be? Whether it be a haul, a lookbook, a makeup tutorial, because it's coming close to that time. I'm gonna be starting back with my regular recording in November. I was thinking to do a lookbook, and then I wanted my second video to be a makeup tutorial, and then I have a little surprise for all my subscribers. So yeah, that's gonna be pretty exciting. Thank you guys so much for subscribing to my channel. Thank you guys so much for watching my videos. I see my views going up, my subscribers are going up. Like, literally, my channel is amazing right now. So I'm so excited, and I'm so thankful and grateful to all of you for the support and the love that you guys show me on my videos and on my channel. But yeah, like I said, I have a surprise for you guys coming soon, so look forward to that, okay? Because I have to show you guys my appreciation, as well, as you guys show me. So yeah, that's it for this vlog, you guys. I'm so sorry. I'm not really doing anything else that's that interesting, you know what I'm saying? So I'll see you guys in the week, probably Monday, because I might be going outside tomorrow to do a quick exchange. So yeah, I'll see you guys on Monday. I love you guys. Thank you guys once again for your love and support, and I will see you guys in my next vlog. Good night.